Audition features Ryo Ishibashi as Shigeharu Aoyama, a widower who, after years of focusing on his career and raising his now teenage son, is finally ready to get back into the dating game. And he does so by agreeing to become the producer of a new TV and radio program that also doubles as the titular audition for his new wife-to-be. Unfortunately for Aoyama, the one he falls for is so much more than meets the eye. Hi, I'm Cinematico Magnifico of AmoralCrackpot.com, and welcome to the Nightly Chill. Audition, from director Takashi Miike and based on the novel by Ryu Murakami, is about 10 or 20 minutes worth of very interesting, very compelling storytelling, character work, and creative sadistic violence. The remaining hour and a half, however, is incredibly dull and aimless. In fact, it often feels as if Miike were casually killing the clock, biding his time until the final moments to turn his otherwise uneventful drama about a lonely widower on its head. While I'm unfamiliar with Murakami's original novel, I'd have to assume that either the book is fairly short and to the point, or at the very least incredibly cerebral, because there's little other reason why Miike's film is so lean. The basic story itself and acting and visual and audio aspect of the film are fine. Takashi Miike is a director who has long proved himself to be incredibly talented behind a camera, but there's simply nothing going on screen for the majority of the movie until the movie's disturbing climax. Aside from a few bizarre or unnerving images, which are still too few and far between, Miike does little to nothing to keep the story interesting or the visuals popping. Now yes, the dullness of practically every single scene does reflect the overall mental state of Aoyama. This is a man who lost the woman he loved, the mother of his child. This is a man who chose to wallow in his loneliness for what seems to be a good 10 years. He works in entertainment, but he's not working on any big or exciting project. His life is just a haze of dull moments, briefly shaken up by a quaint exchange with his son, or something surprising. Even his dates with Eihi Shina's deeply disturbed Asami are uncomfortably dull, as to be expected of a middle-aged man long removed from dating. But that still doesn't excuse giving the audience nothing to care about for the vast majority of 2 hours. Yes, the movie's climax is every bit as disturbing as fans of the movie have led everyone to believe, but it's also over in a matter of minutes. It simply isn't worth the long, boring wait. If all the talk about Audition's disturbing violence has you interested, then please skip right ahead to the main course. Don't think you're missing anything of value or substance by doing so. Audition is the sort of movie to invite you out for the evening while only being interested in one thing, and won't even pretend to hold a conversation or display much in the way of a personality. It only wants to kill the clock until it can take you back to its place and give you, at best, 5 minutes in heaven before it rolls over and falls asleep almost immediately afterward. And for most people, outside of those great 5 or so minutes, Audition is a no-chill. That's gonna do it for us tonight on The Nightly Chill. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, subscribe, and follow, and also be sure to leave me any questions, comments, suggestions for future reviews, and maybe even discuss today's movie at greater length. And as always, this video is brought to you in part by our viewers. If you'd like to learn how to support this and other projects, please visit amoralcrackpot.com or check the description below. But until next time, y'all need to make like a tree and get out of here.